Hey guys, it's Maria.
This is Tim.
Today is Wednesday, April the 25th, 2018. Welcome to our daily recap.
Maria, before we get started, let's go ahead and give the closing numbers, please.
Absolutely. The Dow ended the day up 59 points, closed at 24,083. NASDAQ was down 3 points and closed at 7,003. The S&P 500 was up 4 points and closed at 2,639.
Exciting day. A lot to go over. I mean, a lot to go over today. So let's start off with some low floats. And I wanted to start off, actually, you know what? That after-hour scanner. Let's go ahead and show everybody the after-hour scanner. This is something that you don't see anywhere else. We're the only ones that give you after-hours volume. So right there, Cat B, live volume, O'Reilly. Watch those move as, you know, you'll see them as volume comes in, like Facebook's getting plenty of volume there, over 9 million shares traded. But you can watch that live just to see it just ticked. So every time that trades, that's only after hours volume. That is not during the day. That starts over as soon as the market closes, it starts over fresh. So, Maria, let's go ahead and start with Dare. That was a pretty kick-ass play today.
Absolutely. Let's look at it. And I'm going to pull up the 5-day so that you can see what it did. There's your 5-day.
Yeah. So what was the news on this one? Because I'm looking at this, and this traded like an insane amount of volume. I'm going to want you to pull up the volume ratio on this one as well. 420 times its average 10-day volume. That's,
so the news,
that's sick.
Really quickly. So the news was that they entered into an exclusive worldwide license agreement for Juniper.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So that's pretty sick news. But look at that after hours volume. I mean, not the day volume on this thing. And this is something we like to look at. This is shows the 10-day average volume, right? So as you can see, Dare traded 420 times its average 10-day volume.
Wow.
That's insane.
That's
one of the largest
of volume.
Yeah, that's one of the largest I've ever seen. So I did want to get that out there. Let's keep that one on watch. Absolutely. That could have some room to go. Maria, EVLV, wanted to talk about that one as well. We've talked about it a couple times lately.
So we talked about it last night. And today we have, you know, again, it continued forming that base of a cup and handle. So let's see what it does tomorrow. I like where it held support on the day.
Love the close. Love the close.
Yeah, really nice close.
And across there, it looks about like a dollar, just a little bit above a dollar, maybe a dollar or two, is pretty strong support.
Yep.
If I'm seeing that right. And did we find any news with that one yesterday?
Let's double check. Oh, this is that Amazon acquisition one.
That's what it was. That's what it was. Okay. I knew there was some reason we were talking about this one. I like it. I would, a dollar would be my stop, maybe 99, just in case they hit the dollar to hit stops, but 99 cents would probably be my stop on this one if I was playing it. And, you know, one that kind of blew my mind that it didn't get more action was Mankind, because to me, it's really a great drug. The FDA news, I thought, was very bullish on it.
Yeah.
Those longs are probably about as patient as you could ask anybody to be. But I want to pull up a longer-term chart on Mankind as well. I really, really had my hopes up on this one.
So here's a yearly chart on it.
Yeah, let's go back maybe 3 months.
So 3 months is right here.
Yeah. I mean, it's you can see where they had that big run a couple months ago. Epic run. I mean, we had options in it. We had options flow in it. A lot of people, I know AJ had a 5,500% win in Mankind. I know that sounds crazy, but the options were cheap. It was a sick play. But this one right here, I'm still going to keep my eye on it because, you know, that drug announcement really, to me, I know it means a lot to the shareholder. So fingers crossed for Mankind. I do like that company. eBio, let's go ahead and pull up eBio as well.
So here is the 5-day on eBio. And yesterday, guys, we drew a line right here at 211 is what I wanted to see eBio hold. Nice move, nice continuation up. I love that it found a higher level of support right around this 226.
And that one is another 52-week high today. Didn't close at the 52, but it was a new 52-week high today. I believe yesterday was as well. Matter of fact, I know it was. So let's keep an eye on eBio. The volume is still good. Have no problem there. Almost about 1.75 times its average on eBio. Another one we talk about a lot. Still going to continue to talk about until it does something to stop us is GERN, G-E-R-N.
So here's your weekly, close enough to, I'll call it a double bottom between yesterday and today. that I want to continue watching this.
I like Gurn. I like Gurn. Another one that's just, you know, the board's just kick-ass, a bunch of Lowell Long, so really like Gurn. And until it gives me a reason not to, I'm going to continue to watch this. One, you know, and I hate to bring this one up, but we had said it a couple times in the room yesterday, and especially this morning when it gapped up, check. C-H-E-K gives a whole new meaning to yesterday's heroes, tomorrow's zeros. And check, the way that was straight up in this morning's gap, which was just sick, and it sold off the rest of the day, that was very concerning. I did not like that gap we had this morning. I told everybody, let's avoid this one. I do like where it closed there. You got basically a triple, quadruple bottom. It make and it's also where it had resistance before, so check, it may hold here. So I definitely want to keep it on watch because I do like where it found support. The news on this thing, we couldn't find any news other than compliance a few days ago, which I didn't think was necessary for this kind of run. But I do like where it found support, and I hope that holds. If it does, we'll you know, you could have this one going in the future as well. So we'll keep an eye on check for sure. EYPT, Maria. And we were supposed to talk about this one last night. I had took it off the list because my phone was going dead. And EYPT, good day yesterday. Nice move off, you know, decent consolidation. And we should have talked about it yesterday. Today, it just absolutely kicked ass. And let's go ahead and pull this up. Probably news in the last couple of days after that run. I don't see it.
This is a weekly on it. And the last news I have for them was on the 19th. They announced that they were going to release their earnings on Tuesday, May the 8th. And let's look a little bit further out on this one. Let's do that. Wow. Holy crap. Look at that. That's a year.
Okay. Now we're getting somewhere.
Here's 3 years. So we're looking at resistance. Well, it looks like it could just continue right through it. I'm going to call some right here, 262 or so. Let's say 255 to 262.
Yeah, 255 is where it stopped today, which was a 52-week high on this thing.
Yeah.
EyePoint Pharmaceuticals, definitely want to keep an eye on EyePoint Pharmaceuticals as well. STNG, that one had some serious, serious options flow about 3 weeks ago, and they released earnings today. And that options flow, we had some people in the room that held through all this, you know, the last couple of weeks. That options flow, they kicked ass. So I do want to keep seeing STNG on the radar. This is one we'd actually watched a few months ago as well, but brought it up again in the last 20, 30 days. Actually, it was this month that they had all that flow. Upgraded to buy from hold from DNB Markets. That was today even. So good. Yeah. Keep an eye on this one. There was a ton of flow. It never gets flow. So I definitely want to keep an eye on this one. One more, a couple more on the low floats. MDXG.
Really nice day. Nice move.
Solid. Let's go ahead and pull this one back 20 days or so.
Yeah, let me add this line right here, and let's go 20 days. Here's a 20-day.
Shit, let's go out a little farther.
Sure thing. Let's try 6 months. So through that first resistance area, the next resistance, it's getting close if you're looking at these wicks over here where I just highlighted. Yeah, it's getting real close to it.
I would put one on the top of that other red candle as well, maybe. Yeah, that one.
Yeah, that's the one I like. So immediate resistance, probably around 865 or so, 860, 850 to 860. Above that, you're looking, I think you'll see a little bit at 9 and then 920.
After that, you can start looking at 10s, 11s, and then you got a gap. So definitely want to keep that one in mind. LEDS, last low float I have.
Absolutely. Let me go to a 5-day. Here's your 5-day. So yesterday, we drew this line here at 403. That's what we wanted to see it hold. And it bounced off right above it. And we saw some buying come in. Just going to continue to watch it for possible continuation.
We have a lot of options flow to go over today. And I do want to get out real quick. If you ever want a free trial with Black Box or in us in the chat rooms, because we do trade live all day, every day, several hundreds of us, really good traders, hit us up for a free trial on here, StockTwits or Twitter. So I want to get that out there. Maria, before we get into these earnings plays, I wanted to go over a little of the flow. YNDX. Now, YNDX gets some flow, but today they shot some, I mean, just bombs at it on YNDX. So a couple of people in the room did play it. And yeah, so today's action, you see right there where it started, the second yellow one at 1244, started at 290, 175 grand. 294, 310, 330, 340, almost 350. This is the same buyer. This is the same buyer. This all happened in 2.5 minutes. And you're looking at, I think it was close to, oh, I actually kept going. That 2 million block was with it as well. And that went to 355. So it was over $3 million through at YNDX by one buyer out to August. So keep an eye on that as well. YNDX out to August, 34 calls, not far out of the money. Stock actually jumped. That one big candle there toward the end of the day was more than one candle. But that was when this flow started coming in. So it did push it up. So I do like this flow. Very aggressive buyer. So I want to keep that on radar. Also, one we played in the room this morning, several of us, you and Vishal caught the first flow, and then I caught that third one, Adobe, ADBE. We played this live, and just a kick-ass play. And I wish we'd actually swung it. The first one come through. Now, these weren't yellows or purples, meaning, you know, OI hadn't been met or OI wasn't exceeded in one trade. But you don't see a lot of flow in Adobe, right? So that first one come through for 115,000 at 904, two 20s for 518. And I don't know if it was you or Vishal that had mentioned the first one. Then one of you mentioned the second one. Hey, there's another one. Somebody bought 156,000. These are both on the ask, right? So we know that these are, you know, aggressive buyers. The third one, that's when I seen it there. I'm like, hey, we just got a sweep for 176,000 above the ask. So this guy didn't care. He just wanted in. Right then is when we all started going in Adobe, and we had just a good play on that 40-50% real quick. And God, if we would have held those, no telling what they'd been worth tomorrow. But I'm just a really, really good play. You're actually love that. That figures. Me and Vishal are out. And that's the thing. They don't always have to be yellow or purple, but we knew we didn't see much flow in Adobe, and those ask above the ask was our sign to buy. So we nailed Adobe. WFC. I want to hit the flow on that one too. Pretty aggressive buyer in WFC as well. And I know we had a couple people jump in this. I did not. I'm not a big bank guy, but you see that $3 million on the ask down there at 12:59:33. Okay, so even the fly caught it too. So that's interesting. Right, the 26,000 on 11,000 OI. Okay, so yeah, that's the one that started it. I didn't know the fly had put that out, but we caught that caught our attention very quickly. I don't know how that was closed, but we did have some people play that. Again, we love flow. THO. THO, you don't get a ton of flow in. And more often than not, it works out. Now, we've seen some in the 120s recently that didn't work out so well, but this one did. This one did, and this was the same buyer, in my opinion, because it started at 10.11, stopped at 10.15. But the first one, 760, 788, 760 again, you know, as the stock had come down. Thor had a good day after that. If you look at what time on the chart was it when that flow came in, Maria? So that was at 10.11. So put that on your cursor on 10.11 real quick.
So it would have been over here, somewhere through here, right before this pop.
God, that was 10 o'clock. The stock did move off that. Those contracts are green. We did not take a position in this one, not a new position in this one. Twitter, I want to go over the flow in Twitter. Twitter, massive, massive fucking day on flow. A few puts in there as well, but this one, not many. I mean, look at that. You're looking at 90% calls going across there, and it was that way the whole day. They beat on ER. They had some upgrades as well. Maria, you can go over those. But, you know, the calls just kept coming in, and Twitter did do a pretty good rebound off that. So some people got paid on those calls already. So I just wanted to go over the Twitter flow. And Maria, what were the upgrades?
So the first one was Raymond James upgrades to market perform from underperform. UBS upgrades Twitter to a buy. New price target, $36 from $32. So they went from a neutral to a buy. And they went from a 32 price target to a 36 price target. And those were the two upgrades that I saw today.
Here's one that some people played in the room this morning. Vishal had brought up early. Cat. Look at Cat. Now, Cat, we all know, and we talked about it last night, kind of fucked up the market yesterday as far as I was concerned. And the flow in Cat today, not many puts, especially after a day like yesterday. People were actually coming in. Now, there was some pretty nice sweeps there early in the morning, all on the ask. That 713,000 for May 18th, the 143s. Talk about getting paid. That guy just got paid. And some people did follow that flow, and they worked out. As far as I know, they sold and nice profits today. Again, the way the market's acting, we took profits where we could get them. I didn't play it. Several people did play those. But nice day, and they caught that. What time did that thing start shooting up, Maria? Because that trade came in at 8:35. So right there on the dip, 9:15. Yeah.
Correct. So
what
9:15.
What time was that on the Shern?
Right before the pop. Right before it started
right
moving
before
up.
The pop. Yeah. So they bought on that again because it was aggressive. It was on the ask, nice size, and they caught that whole move. And so good job on that. BA, Maria, let's hit BA real quick, and then we'll go over some ERs. And I want to show you this one right here. And Maria, I know this came in very early this morning. The one for $559,000 there. Bought the 322.50s in the money when the stock was at 331 for $11. Expiring this week. So it was a little risky before the conference call. Boeing upgraded to a buy from hold at Vertical Research. I don't know them, but look at the price of those calls. $559,000. Very aggressive for weekly, even though it was in the money. Yeah, what are the price on those now? Let's pull those up. The 322.50s. Oh, my God. This guy, he just made so much money. 322.50s are at 21.50. I'm sorry. They closed at 1981. So that guy just made $500,000. Nice play. So we did have some people that actually played Boeing today. Maria, you were one up. I know you've probably got a confirm on this, right?
I made a little over $1,000 on it. Really kind of chasing it too. Those contracts moved really, really fast. Oops, let me pull this back over. Yeah, I made a little over $1,000, played a little bit of this run. I didn't even participate until it was, you know, I thought I was chasing it, but it ended up working out nicely.
And Maria, speaking of confirms, I know you played Amazon again today. Yes, you do, usually every day.
So here is the day on Amazon. Sorry, I've got a lot of lines on there. And this is the confirm. So really nice day on Amazon. I did play it short and then I played it long. I kind of wish I had swung some, you know, hit a high after hours of 1484. And that will probably be pretty tomorrow. However, if it's going to move, it'll move tomorrow too. So ER tomorrow definitely could be an exciting day.
Could be an exciting day. And I think tomorrow between Microsoft and Amazon, it's going to really start making or breaking the quarter, even though today Facebook and a few other things kicking some ass, so that's good. Well, let's look at NVIDIA. Now, NVIDIA yesterday on the webinar, which we had bought just a little bit over $220, like $220.60 or something, $230s for May. Was really happy to get those. And then today, all hell breaks loose and ships again this morning, right out of the bat. We did hold that, and people thought we were crazy. We thought this morning was overblown. I wish I'd have doubled down on it, actually, because NVIDIA under 220 was a gift. Is more so of a gift today than yesterday, obviously. We've got Intel reporting tomorrow. That's going to tell us a lot about NVIDIA, but AMD after the bell's got this pumping up. So we are still in the NVIDIAs. I know it looks crazy, but we're still in. Maria, I know you're a big-time bull on NVIDIA as well.
Absolutely. I love NVIDIA. You guys know that. I play it almost every day. I'm still in NVIDIA. I did add to my own position. I picked up just like a couple contracts to complete the position. So now my position's completely complete, or it's all the way complete. So yeah,
I think, like that.
You know, yeah.
Completely complete.
Completely complete.
I'm going to use that every day in something. MU. You told the room today you were adding MU back. You got a pretty nice dip. I don't know which ones you got.
I went with the May 50s.
May 50s?
Mm-hmm.
So that one also looking good after hours. The whole market looks good after hours. So while we're talking about those, let's pull up SMH because we've been getting a lot of flow in SMH, which kind of kept us confident yesterday that chips were oversold. We started seeing the flow, the turnaround in SMH. And
I'm holding SMH actually.
Yeah, Vishal, several of us are holding SMH. Yeah, very, very few puts in SMH. This was yesterday's flow, right?
Yep, this one was yesterday's flow. And then today we had above the ask, a sweep on the 97s for May 4th. Nice size block, or not, sorry, nice size sweep for SMH.
Yep. So we did like that. I know somebody's going, well, there's a $200,000 put on there. It was, looks like it was sold. And let's go ahead. Maria, let's go ahead and go over, get this wrapped up. Let's go ahead and go over the ERs that we had after hours. You've got several that's just kicking ass. Facebook's kicking ass. Let's look at that after hours scanner for a second. O'Reilly up 11%. AMD up 11.4%. So Maria, that on the after hours scanner here, let's go ahead and get these earnings that's in play. Right now, AMD killing it. Over 13, almost 13 and a half million shares traded up 11%. Let's go ahead and pull up a chart on AMD.
Here's the daily, hit a high of 1085 after hours. Let's go out like 6 months. I think that we have a little bit of resistance right around 11 up to roughly about 11, Let's say 11 to 11:10. 11 puts you right here.
That. Monster day for the Bulls as this continues. So, yeah, the conference call must have went well, which is where we've seen them mess up in the past. We are holding, God, we've got 13s for way out. I think we've bought 13s for January and, what, June or July?
July.
Yeah, and let's go ahead and pull up Facebook after hours. And Facebook had monster flow today. It's traded 11 million shares after hours. 11 million shares at $170, $171.85 right now. But just put that in perspective of how much money that is. I'm not even going to do the math right now. It's a lot. It's traded over $1 billion after hours. That's insane.
And thankfully, the conference call is going well.
Yeah, thankfully, the conference call is going well. Yeah, AMD and Facebook are notorious for fucking up during a conference call. Just absolutely notorious. So, yeah, let's pull up a Facebook chart. So, back to 170 on this thing, 171.
You'll run into some resistance right around, actually, I'm going to go with up here. See a little bit of resistance through here and here. And that puts us right around 173.
Yeah, 173, 175 is going to be a big number just because it's a big fat hole number. 177.50 looks interesting on that chart.
There is also a little bit of a gap that, you know, once it makes its way up, it could try to fill.
That would be good. We really needed Facebook because of the way the market's been acting, just funny as fuck. We really needed Facebook to report well. So good job on that one. O'Reilly up 11.7% after hours on 310,000 shares. You might get some sympathy there with Advanced Auto Parts and what's the other one, Maria? So
AAP or kind of, AZO, AutoZone.
AutoZone. So you may get a run in those two just in sympathy. UCTT beat low volume, 109,000. CMG, Maria, when's the last time we've seen CMG at 373?
Goodness. Holy crap. Yeah, talk about a move. That is a beautiful, beautiful move. Let's get a year pulled up.
Let's get a year pulled up on that one for sure.
So it's at 373. It was back over here somewhere. That's 395, 360. So back, geez, has it been, was it July of last year?
It's been a long time.
Wow.
So, I mean, yeah, I mean, really the resistance, you know, if you get through that gap, geez, 400.
This is 391 right here. And then we also have, this is, that's 374. And this is 380.
Yeah, so 374 is where it's bumping up against right now. So we get through that one, then you could be looking at, I mean, this thing can run. I mean, CMG, there's no telling how many shorts in this thing. I like the burritos. So CMG, monster play. We had one of the newer guys in the room. He was swinging five calls on this one. He just mopped up. Matter of fact, he was a trial member that just went yearly. So congrats to him.
So CMG, just so you guys can see what happened this quarter or why they're moving. Number one, they approved an additional $100 million for stock buyback. So nice buyback there. They see their same store sales up low to single digits for full year 2018. They reported Q1 EPS 213 on a consensus of $1.57. Came in line on rev. They reported $1.15 billion on a consensus of $1.15 billion.
Yeah, let's go ahead and pull up the numbers for Facebook as well.
Sure.
I did skip those.
So here's the Facebook chart again, guys, just so you have something to reference. Facebook, they did a huge buyback. They authorized an additional $9 billion. $9 billion, which is gorgeous. So authorized an additional $9 billion on their buyback. Their quarter, they reported EPS $1.69 on a consensus of $1.35, revenue $11.97 billion on a consensus of $11.41 billion. Their daily active users, they came in for Q1 at 13%, monthly active users up 13%.
That's huge.
So a lot of really good info coming out of Facebook tonight.
So let's keep our eyes on that one big time. Visa, one of our favorites, and we are long-term Visa bulls. And that one, after hours, very nice on ER. It's right up against resistance right now.
Yep, that 125.
Let's go ahead and that 125. It's got to get through this 125. And it had some problems there earlier this week. We have some new members that's actually swinging YOLO Visas. They had 122s for this week. They are looking pretty nice right now. Yeah, this 125, Maria, that's where we've got to get through. And if we do, we could see all-time highs on Visa. Great quarter. Go ahead and pull that up real quick. And then I'm just going to mention a couple real briefly. We won't chart them. We'll just mention them. Shut this down.
Sure. So Visa, they reported Q2 adjusted EPS $1.11 on a consensus of $1.02. Q2 revenue $5.1 billion on a consensus of $4.81 billion. Nice beat on both the top and bottom. Their Q2 payment growth up, or they came in at 11%. Process transactions 12%. So they actually cut their full year revenue growth to low single digits from high single digits. They said their Visa and PayPal partnership is going well. That they said they're looking to expand.
You know, speaking of PayPal, they beat after hours as well. And PayPal traded 892,000 shares, up 5.2%, 77.86. Beat also up AAP. We talked about that in sympathy. It's up 7.6% on 70,000 shares. So that one, yeah, that one's already pulling a sympathy play. Really, Xilinx is up. Align is up, Maria. That's one of your favorites. Align, it's low volume, 179,000 on five, and it's up 5%. Qs are obviously up. Go ahead and pull up the Qs. Let's look at the Qs. And we are swinging Qs. That's another thing that we like to do in the room when days, the ERs come out just blasting. We all grab some Q calls because you can do that for 15 minutes after the market closes. Everything else in options is done, but the Qs, we can grab them for 15 minutes. Gorgeous day.
Yeah. We
got a short early, some longs on the Qs. Not even going to bore you with trade confirms, but look at this after hours.
We've picked up 160s, right? Right. It was like 4:13 p.m. or 4:14, like literally a minute and a half left.
Yeah. The guy that said, hey, we've got 2 minutes left to pick up the Qs. And we're like, oh, shit. So we started getting orders ready. He goes, we got 1 minute left. So we did get some Qs, and those are just kicking ass after hours. So I want to thank him. And Maria, I don't have anything else really. Intuit has news, right?
Intuit did have some news. They were, last I saw them, they were up a little bit after hours. Yeah, they hit, wow, 182.25 sitting at the high. They reported a 6% increase in TurboTax online units.
That's pretty good.
And they raised their full year consumer group guidance range. They also announced that they will be reporting their third quarter and full year 18 results on May the 22nd.
Okay.
So Intuit, I actually like a lot. I like the stock a lot. Here's a 1 year chart on it. It's, you know, it was just gorgeous all of last year. A little bit of volatility, but still, you know, moving really nicely. So I'm actually considering picking up some calls on this one. I'm not in yet. I will let you guys know if I decide to go in.
Thank you. Thank you. I like Intuit too. Nice chart. And I don't have a lot else. I mean, just a great day. We've got Amazon tomorrow. We've got some ERs in the morning, Maria, and tomorrow. You want to hit those real quick?
Yeah. So ERs, we have tomorrow in the morning, AbbVie, one of my favorites, DPS, Raytheon, AAL, GM, Love, Nokia, BMY, DPZ, and Altria, MO. After hours, we have Amazon, Microsoft, Intel, WDC, Starbucks, Baidu, I believe Cypress Energy is tomorrow as well. I need to double check on that one. Don't quote me on that one. Southwest Energy, is that Expedia? Let's double check on Expedia too. But yeah, I'll double check on the ones that I wasn't sure about, but the rest are definitely tomorrow.
Cypress, you're talking about Cypress Semiconductor, CY. They have ER tomorrow.
Yeah, they are. That's what I was talking about. And then Expedia is tomorrow. So I was correct on both of those.
This is going to be the biggest earnings day as far as I'm concerned of the quarter is tomorrow. So hopefully we'll be playing some Qs after hours. We'll actually be playing them long or short one way or another, I'm sure. So let's get that ready. And that's what I love about the room.
Sorry, I got excited.
What was it you said? I didn't even hear you.
I said NVIDIA 222.77.
Yeah, we needed that. We'll actually be green in those tomorrow. So if you want a free trial, hit us up. And Maria, that's all I've got. I don't know about you.
That's all I have, guys. Thanks for joining us tonight. As always, again, if you have questions or tickers or topics that you would like us to cover, please go ahead and put those in the comments. If you have not already subscribed to our channel, please do so now. Like and share our video for us, please. We would appreciate it. Aside from that, guys, stay careful tomorrow. Stay green, and we will see you later on. Take care. Good night.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.